noose is tightening. The police are closing in on me. They'll be back, and next time, they'll take me in. Agatha was my last chance. She's the only one who seems to understand what's happening to me. I just hope this time she'll give me some answers. Someone just went out the window.
Sir, I need to get your name before I can record your message. Sir, the police cruiser will be there in just a few minutes. Can you hear me, sir?
Agatha. The only one who could help me, the only one who knew. Maybe she left me something. The answer could be here somewhere. Quick, I still have a few minutes to search her apartment before the police get here.
What brings you here, young man? Tell me, what is your cage like?
Brass bathtub, an antique, must be at least a century or two old.
New York police. Anybody there? Hey, Kevin, call an ambulance. There's a body on the floor.
What's up? Anybody home?
Tyler? I didn't expect you so soon. Be a good boy and preheat the oven. Oh, and pour us a couple of glasses of champagne from the fridge. I'll be out in a minute.
Hello, Detective Miles. Do you know what day it is today?
Well, we already had Christmas, so 4th of July? No, that's summer. No, you got me.
Tyler.
Okay, babe. It's been exactly 2 years since I met the woman of my dreams.
You want to put some music on? I feel like dancing.
Tyler gave me a full report on what happened at Nazer and Jones. He emphasized that one of the employees was behaving strangely, a guy named Lucas Kane. Now, I had all the pieces of the puzzle. I just needed to put them all together to find our murderer. On my desk lay all the information from Nazer and Jones. On Tyler's desk, the clues from the restaurant. The identity of the killer was here somewhere. The list of employees at Nacer and Jones. We have the name, address, and photo of everyone who works at the bank. Hey, here's Kane's file. Is he our man? Detective Valenti.
Hi, Carla. It's Garrett. I called to tell you that I sent you the results of the testing we did on the prints on that pen. They should already be in your email.
Perfect. Thanks, Garrett. I'll take a look right away.
The taxi company should have sent you a list of taxi destinations from the same street as the diner the night of the murder. It should be on the fax in your office.
Thanks. Bye, Garrett.
Bye, Carla.
Lucas Kane's fingerprints. killer's prints found on the murder weapon. No doubt about it, the prints from the restaurant and the pen come from the same person. I've got my first link. I'll need another in order to establish proof that Kane is our man. The torn piece of stock list paper that the killer used as a bookmark. Come in.
Oh, hi, Carla. I saw the light was on, so I thought I'd, come in and say hello.
Nice to see you, Martin. It's calmer here at night. It helps me think a little clearer.
Carla, this has been bothering me for a while. I need to talk to you. You see, I saw the killer from the restaurant. He saved a kid who was drowning in Central Park. The kid would have died without him. I was there when it happened. And it's stupid, but I just couldn't bring myself to arrest him after that. I just figured he'd earned a break. I'm really sorry.
Oh, don't feel too bad about it, Martin. I might have done the same thing in your place.
Well, I'll be around for at least another hour. Damn reports to type up. Come and see me if you need some company.
Catch you later, Martin. Stretch my legs a bit. Everything going all right, Martin?
Oh, everything will be great as soon as I'm done with all this damn paperwork.
The list of calls made from the telephone at the restaurant on the night of the murder. The killer might have made one of these calls. The composite photo of the killer. The Shakespeare book found at the suspect's table in the diner. No, no connection between those two elements. Composite photo corresponds exactly with Kane's employment photo. Two strong links to Lucas Kane. That makes him suspect number one. But it's not quite enough to bring him in. If only I had one last piece of proof. Take a look at this. Ever seen this guy before?
That's him. That's the guy from the restaurant.
Are you sure, Martin?
Positive.
This time, there's no reasonable doubt. Lucas Kane is the restaurant killer. I've got to tell Tyler right away.
Sorry, babe. I need to answer it. It might be important.
Tyler, no!
Hello?
We got him, Tyler.
I'm on my way.
Tyler, I'm warning you. If you leave me now, I will never forgive you.
I won't be long, babe. Just sip some champagne and I'll be right back before you know it. I'm sorry, Sam, but this is really important.
What about me? I'm not important? Tyler! All of the pieces together. All that's left is to arrest the killer. Captain Jones has given us everything we asked for. There's no chance of him escaping.
Okay, this is it. Everybody in position.
Copy that.
I'll go in first. You cover me.
Okay. Damn, what the hell is this?
Cover me. I'm gonna check the doors.
He's running now.
He's running across the street. What should I do, Carla?
Stop him. We're coming.
Copy that.
It happened again. Somebody died in the lavamatic. I saw it like I was there. Agatha's dead, so who's gonna tell me what's going on?
Put your hands in the air!
Damn, the police. They already found me. I'll spend the rest of my days rotting in prison, and I'll never find out what really happened. No, it's not gonna happen like that. That's crazy.
We need to catch him. Next time, we won't get away.
Men in the hospital, four wrecked squad cars, a helicopter that just missed blowing up in our faces. Meanwhile, the killer takes a nice quiet ride on the subway. I hope there's a good explanation for all this.
Nothing went according to plan, Captain. The operation was set up by the book and everybody did their jobs, but Kane displayed some abnormal abilities.
Just what are you trying to tell me here? That this guy is Superman? That's your excuse? And you seriously expect me to buy that crap?
Captain, we're not amateurs. If this guy was a tourist, we would have cuffed him and stuffed him in no time. We underestimated him. He's a lot more dangerous than we thought.
I don't give a crap about your two-bit excuses. When the press finds out that Kane slipped through our fingers, they're gonna make me a laughingstock. And the mayor's gonna come looking for my head. Now what is the plan, people? Are you on his trail?
Kane's photo will be in every squad car, train station, and airport. We're going over every inch of his apartment and interrogating his associates. He can't stay hidden forever.
I want every available man on Kane's ass right now. I want him locked up tight in 48 hours or less. You understand me? I want this nut job behind bars before he decides to cut somebody else. Now get out of here!
Carla, I've been looking for you. We found some of Kane's prints in an apartment where we found the dead body of an old lady. And that's not all. There was a double murder last night in a lavamatic. One of the two victims was killed by knife blows to the heart. Garrett's already there. He's waiting for you.
Agatha, is that you? I thought you were...
dead. In a way. But I promised to tell you what I know. And I always keep my word. Listen carefully, Lucas. We have very little time. You are not insane. Neither are you a murderer. You are simply at the wrong place at the wrong time.
Why did they make me commit that murder?
They've turned you into the instrument of a millennial sacrifice. It's a way for them to see what's hidden. They are looking for a little girl. They'll do anything to get her.
Then who made me commit that murder? Who came and sat down at my table in the restaurant?
No one knows his real name. They call him the Oracle. He serves the most powerful of the powerful. They live in shadow, but they have controlled this world since the dawn of time.
They're coming! Save yourself, Lucas! They want your life! Kuetnitlan. In the ancient Mayan civilization. You'll find some of the answers you seek there.
Agatha? Agatha!
Agatha!
Marcus, wake up! What are you doing here? What happened?
The police found me. I managed to get away. I walked all night. I didn't have anywhere else to go, so I came here.
My God. This time you really have to go to the police, Lucas. There is no other solution.
I'm not turning myself in until I understand what happened. I saw Agatha again. Here, just a while ago. She's dead, but she had some things to tell me. I think she wants to help me.
Agatha is dead? Are you telling me that you...
No, I didn't kill Agatha, Marcus. She was dead by the time I got there.
But you're saying that you talked to a dead person? None of this makes any sense.
Something strange is happening to me, Marcus. Since the murder, I find I can do abnormal things. I see visions of certain events before they happen. Sometimes I can even hear what people are thinking. And my body has become much stronger and faster.
Nobody has powers like that. You're not turning into a Superman, Lucas. So what are you going to do? You can't stay here. The police will certainly come to question me, and probably place me under surveillance.
I have to find some place to hide. I'm a fugitive. My description will go out everywhere. At least now I know that there is an explanation. I need to find the people who are behind all of this.
Be careful, Lucas. They'll kill you if they get the chance.
Nothing could be worse than what I see in my visions.
Lucas has gone insane. I'm protecting a murderer. But I can't betray my brother. Dear God, help me. Tell me what I should do.
-5 degrees Fahrenheit. Every day it got a little colder. The whole city seemed to be numbed by the snow and ice. But nobody was worried about it. Go take a look inside, Tyler. I'm gonna talk to Garrett and see if he found anything.
Cool with me. I can't even think out here in this damn cold.
I was waiting for you, Carla.
So, what happened here?
The guy who runs the Lavomatic found the bodies around 5 o'clock this morning when he came to open up. When he tried to get in, it seemed like the door was blocked from the inside. He saw the two bodies through a window and called the cops.
What do we know about the victims?
The man was called Jose Lopez. He works here and was supposed to close up last night. The woman's name was Anita Martinez. She did her laundry here on a regular basis.
Were there any witnesses?
No eyewitnesses. We checked around the neighborhood, but didn't turn up anything. This guy got lucky. He commits a double murder in front of a window, and nobody sees a thing.
Thanks, Garrett. I want to check on a thing or two before I leave. Three or four stabs in the area of the heart. Exactly like the victim in the restaurant. I wouldn't be surprised if the autopsy finds that the arteries were severed. Did you notice this blood over here?
Yeah, I saw that. What do you think it means?
That the murderer was bleeding before he stabbed his victim. Just like in the toilets of the restaurant. A knife stuck in his eye.
Death would have been instantaneous. Bizarre. His wrists are all cut up. Looks like some kind of symbol carved on them. Snake. A snake with two heads. The knife has the same handle as these other tools. It must have come from this toolbox. Bizarre. Why is there blood here? Is this where he cut up his own forearms? Cain left some blood in the toilets, too. Did Cain cut his arms up, too?
Did you notice the key in the lock?
Yeah, I saw that.
There's no other way into this place. How did the killer get out? Doesn't make any sense.
Knife is stuck in his eye. Damn, that's gotta hurt.
Poor girl, she was stabbed from the front. She found out who her killer was at the very last moment. We can still hear the dial tone. She must not have had time to dial the number. Too bad, we could have had a live witness. Here's the victim's laundry. Who would have believed she wouldn't be alive to get it out when it was ready?
Let's go. I've seen enough. What are we supposed to think about this murder? The guy committed suicide after killing the woman? It seems absurd, but it's the only explanation. I don't think Cain had anything to do with what happened at the laundrette. But all the same, there's got to be a link between the two murders.
At Tiffany's place, get my energy back, and figure out what to do next. I'd only been to her new apartment once before. I only had a vague memory of exactly where it was, but I was sure that this was the street.
Thank you.
another homeless person. I get the feeling they're everywhere, and they're watching me. I must be getting paranoid. The police. They're watching Tiffany's apartment, of course. They assumed that I'd show up here looking for a place to hide. I have to find another way in. Tiffany's apartment. If only I could find a way to open it. I think it budged a little. It's open a few inches.
I almost had it. I wasn't too proud about breaking into Tiffany's apartment like a common criminal, but I had no choice. I hadn't eaten in almost a day. I was starting to feel weak and tired. Nothing to eat here. Nothing to eat here.
Extremely cold temperatures remain the top story today, with the thermometer dropping to a new record low of minus 15 degrees. Heavy snowfall caused the temporary closing of the Brooklyn Bridge, and sadly, the cold proved fatal for several homeless persons in Harlem and in the Bronx. Europe has not been spared either. Record lows have been registered in numerous countries.
Mysterious restaurant murderer has been identified. His name is Lucas Kane, a man with no prior problems with the law. He was able to escape last night just as local police officers arrived at his home to arrest him. Tragically, his killing spree continues as he took the lives of an old woman and two others in a laundromat. His motive is still unknown, but experts say he's most unlikely mentally ill. The police have distributed Kane's photo to the media and expect an arrest within...
And for an expert's point of view on the subject, we have with us today one of the most renowned specialists on Mayan civilization, Professor Dmitry Kuryakin of the Mesoamerican University here in New York. Thanks for being with us today, Professor. You've written a fascinating book on Mayan rituals. And I wanted to ask you if...
A specialist in Mayan civilization? He'd known what Tecnotlan means. Gotta meet this Professor Kuryakin.
You have one new message today at 10:41.
Hello, Miss Harper. I'm Detective Carla Valenti from the New York City Police Department. I'd like to ask you a few questions. I'll try calling you back a little later today.
Pictures in all the newspapers. I can be identified by just about anyone in the street now. I'm going to have to be very careful. I guess I'm out of danger for now. I'll wait for Tiffany to get back before I leave.
me? What are you doing here?
The police are looking for me. I needed a place to hide for a few hours.
Lucas, what happened to you? The papers are saying that you killed several people. Is it true?
The whole thing is very complicated. All I can tell you is that I am not a murderer.
I love you, Lucas. I don't want to lose you.
Look, I'm sure they just want to ask you a few questions. Just stay calm, Tiffany, and answer their questions. I'll hide in the apartment. Everything will be fine. You'll see.
Miss Harper? Miss Harper, are you home?
Yes. Just a second. I'm coming.
Keep them waiting anymore. I've got to open the door.
Miss Harper?
Yes?
I'm Detective Tyler Miles, NYPD. I'm working on the Lucas Kane case. I think that you two were romantically involved, isn't that right?
We're involved, yes. But we separated. We broke up about a month ago.
Have you heard from Mr. Kane recently? Has he tried to contact you?
I went by his apartment day before yesterday to pick up the last of my things. We hardly spoke. I haven't heard from him since.
Do you mind if I look around your apartment?
Well, it's just that...
Hey, I'll only be a minute.
Go ahead.
Decorating?
Yes, the apartment wasn't in very good shape, so I've been painting it. It's taking a long time with my job. I don't have much time to...
And what do you do?
I'm a nurse. I work at St. John's Hospital.
Miss, if Kane does try to recontact you, please call me right away. Here's my card. Be careful, Miss. Kane's a very dangerous man.
Hello. My name's Barney.
Detective Carla Valenti.
You've come to see Janus, isn't that right? He's down the second corridor on the right. You're finished. Oh, another power outage. It's the sixth time today. Not surprising, though, with this cold weather. Good thing the hospital's got its own backup generator. Remember, Janus's cell is down the second corridor on the right. One of my colleagues is waiting to open the cell for you. I'll be watching you. Don't worry, you'll be fine.
Thank you, Barney. I wasn't sure exactly what I expected to find out by coming here. Kane was the killer. There was no doubt about that. And yet, I needed to know just what happened in the strange case of the Kirsten killings.
Detectives, I'll wait for you here.
Perfect, thanks. Hundreds of times on the wall of the cell. Why is he obsessed by this symbol? Hello, I'm Detective Carla Valenti of the New York Police Department. I'd like to ask you a few questions, if it's all right with you, of course. I see you like to draw. That's quite nice. What is it exactly?
Why have you gone to the trouble of coming to see me, Detective Valenti? I'm mad, you know. What I have to say is meaningless. Isn't that right?
Maybe you're not sick. Maybe it's that no one has taken the time to really listen to you.
A man and a woman in a laundromat. She's a little overweight, Hispanic looking. Him, he has a knife planted in his eye.
How do you know that?
I was there. I can see through his eyes. Every one of the murders. I'm there.
And you, Anton, why did you kill that man?
I didn't kill anyone. I was just his instrument. I hear his voice in my head, and I see the blood. Always, always. It has to stop.
Who is the murderer?
Nobody knows. Nobody sees him. He leaves no trace in people's memories. But I know he exists. He's among us, invisible. He's everywhere.
But why are these killings happening? Why must these people die?
Oh, the world's not what you think it is. The Orange Clan is secretly running everything. They're watching us, listening to us all of the time. They record what you say. They know what you're doing each second of the day. They're everywhere.
How is this connected to the murders?
They want ultimate power. They want the answer to the question of life. They want to be eternal.
I have to go now, Anton. Thank you for your help.
It's already too late. We're all gonna die from the cold.
It'll be the dawn of a new race. The end of humanity. The end of humanity. Ah, and do you want to know what my drawings mean? The response to all questions. The beginning of the end. Alpha and the Omega. All will end there.
Everything go all right? I'll walk you to the... Damn it! This time it looks serious. It looks to me like our backup electrical generator hasn't kicked in. It'll come on. Sometimes it takes a minute. We'll wait here in the meantime.
What was that noise?
Oh, shit. The cell doors. All of the cell doors have been opened. The electrical outage must have screwed up the autolock system.
What? You mean the patients are free to leave their cells and nothing...
Wait. Don't move. Don't make any noise. We don't want them to locate us here. Just keep cool and we'll wait for the lights to come on. Relax. Stay close to me.
The aid. They got him. I have to move from here or they'll find me too. I don't breathe more calmly. I'm gonna faint. And then they get me for sure. Oh God, hurry. Find a way out of here. Oh no, I hear one coming. He's getting so close. Breathe, Carla. Don't move.
You made it out. I don't know what the hell could have happened. The auto lock system opened all of the cell doors. Are you hurt? Are you sure you're all right?
Great, Barney. I feel great. I love playing hide and seek in the dark with a pack of psychopathic killers.
This man I'd barely seen on TV was my last hope. I didn't know what connection there could be between the Mayans and what had happened to me, but at that point, I was ready to accept any explanation that could make sense out of the nightmare that my life had become. Hello, I'm a journalist, and I have an appointment with Professor Kuryakin.
The professor's waiting for you.
Feminine figurine found on the Pacific coast of Guatemala. Polychrome tripod seat. Origin, Mexico. Head of statue representing Itzama, discovered in Chiapas. Stone stele from Palenque, post-classical period. This fresco, a two-headed serpent, the same shape that I carved on my forearms the night of the murder. Circular altar that was probably used in sacrifices. Early post-classical period. Professor Kuryakin?
Yes?
My name's John Cunningham. We spoke on the phone. I'm a journalist and I'm gathering information for an article I'm writing about the Mayan religion.
Ah, yes, I've been waiting for you, young man.
What paper did you say you write for once again?
In fact, I'm a freelance journalist. I write articles and sell them to whoever wants to publish them.
It's curious, but your face seems familiar to me. Have we met somewhere before?
Yeah, I get that a lot. I guess I must have one of those boring faces everybody sees everywhere.
Well then, let's have a go at it. Where would you like to start?
Can you tell me anything about Kweknitlan?
Of course. Come, I'll introduce you. You see before you the ancient Mayan god Kweknitlan, the serpent with the two heads. One head sees in this reality, the second in the other world. By opening both mouths, the Mayan oracles could see through the serpent into the other world.
Could you explain this other world?
Oh, the world beyond our own, the kingdom of the gods and the dead. The Mayans believed that human sacrifices allowed them to hear the voices of the deceased and see into the future.
What exactly do we know about these oracles?
Oh, not very much. They were very mysterious. They served as mystic liaisons, allowing man to connect with supernatural forces. If we can believe the ancient texts, the oracles possessed strange powers.
What kind of powers did the oracles possess?
Some passages mention a supernatural life force permitting the oracle to live for several hundred years.
Tell me, how did the sacrificial ceremony work?
Come, I'll show you. This painting, dating from first century BC, shows a sacrificial ceremony. The victim's agony must have lasted quite some time, the priority being to keep the mouths open as long as possible. The victim was stabbed 3 times, each wound cutting a pulmonary artery leading to the heart.
The oracle is not the one stabbing the victim?
Oh, the oracle must never soil himself with the blood of another. That is why he chooses a sort of proxy, another person in the crowd, totally at random. This person becomes the executor. The oracle takes complete control of the executor, manipulating him from a distance.
Mayan sacrifice. That's what it was.
You aren't a journalist, are you? Who are you?
My name is Lucas Kane. The police are looking for me about a murder that I did not commit, but I was the executor.
You're a murderer?
I'm innocent. I stabbed someone I'd never seen before 3 times, cutting his arteries, just like you described.
Do you mean to say that there is a Mayan oracle still living today? But that's completely impossible.
Have you ever seen this symbol before?
Oh, it's the symbol of Kweknitlan. The executors cut this into their own forearms before accomplishing the sacrifice. So, it is true. My God, the Codex was right.
Codex? What are you talking about, Professor?
You can't stay here. Your picture is in the paper that the security guard is reading. He's sure to recognize you. Come, let's leave here, and I'll tell you all about it.
Professor!
The Codex speaks of the coming of a child, a prophet, the answer to all of life's questions. The Oracle kills to find the child.
Resisting an oracle. What is there so different about you? The chroma. You have the chroma. So that explains it. How did you ever acquire such a power? No matter. What matters is, the time has come for you to die.
The chroma? What does that mean?
The force that created the universe. The origin of everything. It gives extraordinary powers to those who possess it.
This is some kind of dream, isn't it? You're not really there in front of me, are you?
Reality is a notion that doesn't have any meaning where I come from. We are not really here. And yet, you will die here. Believe me, this world is just as real as your own. Enough talk. Other matters await my attention. We will see each other again. In the other world. Kibin Tinna Quintaune.
Lucas, those who employ the Oracle are searching for a little girl, a perfectly pure soul that's never been incarnated. Her coming was foretold by the most ancient prophecy in human history. She's the one you see in your dreams. You must find her before the Oracle does and put her someplace safe. Hurry, there isn't much time and they are already back on your trail.